upon your life. And what you have started to do already will so continue in your life. You'll never, never, never be the same again. Fulfillment, fruitfulness, power, provision, a breakthrough, success, great, great outpouring of the manifold blessing of God upon your life. The Lord has started already. He will continue until He finishes, until He saturates your life. The goodness of God, the goodness of heaven, and you'll find that the grace of God will be abundantly sufficient for you. Pray that the Lord will not pass you by, that the blessings of the Lord will not pass you by, that this great, mighty thing the Lord has started already will continue your life until all the purposes of God will be realized, will be fulfilled. Welcome the grace of God into your life. Welcome the goodness of God into your life. Welcome the abundance of God into your life. He brought you here to bless you. He has started already. And every step of the way that He leads you will give you a realization, a fulfillment, an accomplishment of that which He plans and which He purposes for you. In Jesus' name we pray. And the church of the living God said, God bless you. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you and we bless you. We exalt your name at this time for the great things you have started, which you will continue. Lord, we pray that at this time there will be an outpouring of manifold blessings of God upon your people in Jesus' name. We're asking, oh Lord, that every one of us, from the top to the bottom, from the greatest to the least, from all the members to the workers, our ushers, our security, our choir, our orchestra, and all the people are walking that we don't see, but you see them. Oh Lord, we pray at this time an abundance of outpouring in Jesus' name. We're asking, Lord, in all the retreat locations, as you are blessing your people here, you'll be blessing everyone over there too, in Jesus' name. Lord, we pray, as you have ordained and planned and purposed, this retreat will be unforgettable. The blessings will be unforgettable. And Lord, we pray, all the blessings you give us in this retreat will be permanent in Jesus' name. Bless your people even at this time too. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. God bless you. You can sit down. At this time now, we come to a Bible teaching session. Remember that the whole theme we're talking about is unlimited riches and hidden treasure. And God has invited you here. God has brought you here so that those unlimited riches, they will be yours. And those hidden treasures, they will be yours in Jesus' name. You need to discover them. And you need to experience them. And then you need to enjoy them. And you need to keep them so that it will not just be what God pours out upon us at the retreat. It will be something that will go through the whole year and through your lifetime. God is doing something. He will perfect it in your life. This time we're talking about indispensable steps to spiritual fulfillment. That is, it's like there is an upstairs. And then right at the top, we can see the spiritual fulfillment. And you know, if I can just climb step after step in the staircase, once I get to the top, I will have that spiritual fulfillment. That means every expectation of my life, every desire of my life, every need of my life. That means all the things I've been dreaming about and desiring. It means over there, if I can just climb 1, 2, 3 steps, then I get there. We're going to get there in Jesus' name. And when you get there, untold blessings, innumerable blessings, wonderful blessings will come upon your life in Jesus' name. The very fact that you step on this ground, the very fact that you are here, you are blessed already. I said you are blessed already. I want you to say, I am blessed. Come to the person right by your side and look them face eyeball to eyeball and say, you are blessed. Nobody will escape the blessing of God. You're on, it will run after you. You stand, it will stand with you. You sit, it will sit with you. You are blessed in Jesus' name. We're looking at Psalm 36. Psalm 36, I'm reading from verse 7. Psalm 36, verse 7. How excellent is thy loving kindness, O God! Therefore, the children of men put their trust under the shadow of thy wings. The psalmist is just rejoicing as he recollects the blessings of God. The psalmist is recollecting how God had blessed the people of God in the past. And he said, this is wonderful. And he said, this is marvelous. And he said, in fact, you know, sometimes when our teachers, when they grade our papers in school, sometimes some of those teachers, maybe they didn't teach well, they'll say very poor, yours will not be very poor. Sometimes they'll say fair, you even go beyond fair. And then they will say, good, I think it has been good for your life. And then they will say, very good. And then beyond very good, they will say, excellent. I'm telling you, I'm going to have excellent blessings. You are going to have excellent blessings. That's what the psalmist was looking at. The psalmist looked at his life. And he looked at everything the Lord had been doing. And then he said, how excellent is thy loving kindness, O God. Therefore the children of men, they put their trust under the shadow of thy wings. They shall be abundantly satisfied. Didn't I tell you? That's why we came here. They shall be abundantly satisfied. Say, I will be abundantly satisfied. It will be unto you according to your confession. They shall be abundantly satisfied in the fatness of thy house, and thou shalt make them drink of the rivers of thy pleasure. For with thee is the fountain of life. In thy light shall they see light. There will be no darkness in your way. We're talking about steps, indispensable steps. That means compulsory steps. That means the steps you and I must take. And I'm telling you, some people already here, in fact, many people here who have taken the steps already. All you're expecting now, you're going to get to the top where that spiritual fulfillment will be yours in Jesus' name. Now for our friends, our neighbors, our invitees, and even some of our people who are still to take the steps, we're going to show the steps. And as we show the steps, you will get there with us. There are 3 points we're going to look at in the message. Number one, repentance of all sins. Very simple. That's one step. That as you are approaching the fulfillment, and you are approaching the fruitfulness, and you are approaching the accomplishment of the power and of the purpose of God in your life, Number one, repentance of all sins. Number two, reconciliation with all saints and sinners. Reconciliation. Number one step, repentance. Number two step, reconciliation. Number three, righteousness through the Savior. Righteousness through the Savior. I'm looking at number one. What's number one again? Repentance of all sins. Some people do not know that actually repentance leads us into fulfillment, into fruitfulness, into provision, and into the accomplishment of the plan and the purpose and the promises of God in our life. They think forgiveness is, you know, they think that repentance is when you cry, you roll on the ground, you're so bothered, you're a terrible sinner. It's beyond that. I pray God will open our eyes. Number one, repentance of all sins. Acts of the Apostles, chapter 3. Acts of the Apostles, chapter 3. I'm reading from verse 19. Repent ye therefore and be converted, that your sins may be blotted out, when the times of refreshing shall come from the presence of the Lord. And then it says, and he shall send Jesus, which before was preached unto you. Do you see here what repentance draws into your life? The goodness of God, the grace of God, the manifold blessings of God, the refreshing, the fulfillment that repentance will draw into our lives. Look at that verse 19 and look at it very carefully. In verse 19, repent ye therefore and be converted. What if I repent? What if I'm converted? What else will happen? What will heaven do? And what will God do? What will Jesus bring into my life? If I repent, it's right there. It says that your sins may be blotted out. That means God will take an heavenly eternal eraser, milking, and then all the sins you have committed since you were born, it'll blot everything out. That nobody will be able to reach that righteousness again. That means angels will not be able to reach. Even God will not see the sins anymore. They are blotted out. Just one act of repentance. Just one act of turning away from all the sins you have committed. And you say, Lord, I am sorry. Just those simple words. It says, repent ye and be converted. A change, a transformation, a conversion, a kind of replacement. You are here now, and then it takes you to another place. And then it says, number one, your sins will be blotted out. I say, they are blotted out. I said, they are blotted out. And you know, if you went to the court, and some people had written some terrible things about you, and the judge was sitting there, wanting to accuse you, wanting to condemn you, wanting to pass a sentence on you, wanting to throw you into jail. And then he opens the record. Something happened. He couldn't see anything to read. All the accusation, all the condemnation, everything that was written against you, everything had been blotted out, cleaned out, erased, wiped out. And the judge says, why are you bringing this man here? Why is this woman here? And the prosecutor says, well, his charges are there. And the judge looks at the charges. He cannot find anything. He says, I cannot find anything to reach against the man, against the woman. What will happen? I said, what will happen? They'll set you free. They'll say, go your way. No sentence, no verdict, no judgment, no imprisonment, no condemnation. That's what God has done in Christ. That's why he says, all you need to do is to take this first step. And he says, repent. That just means simply just turn away. Just turn your back on everything that you did before. And then he says, and you'll be converted. And then he says, that your sins may be blotted out. He says another thing in that verse 19. When the times of refreshing, you're coming to fresh air. You're coming to fresh kind of experience in your life. Everything negative has been taken away from all your records. The ordinance of things reaching against you, they have been blotted out. And in terms of refreshing shall come from the presence of the Lord. And he shall send Jesus, which was preached unto you. Look at verse 26. In verse 26, it says, unto you. Say unto me. Unto you. First, God, having raised up his son Jesus, sent him to bless you in turning away every one of you from his iniquities. When he turns us away from our iniquities, he also blesses us. The Almighty God has sent his son Jesus Christ to bless us. The moment you turn away from those sins, you are blessed in Jesus' name. In Ezekiel chapter 18, I'm reading from verse 30. Ezekiel chapter 18, looking at verse 30. It says, at the beginning, therefore, I will judge you, O house of Israel, everyone according to his ways, says the Lord God. I'm surprised as I look at Bastachi. God just said, I will judge. Then immediately, he wanted to show us the step to clear up the judgment. He wanted to show us the way to clear up the condemnation. After saying at the beginning, therefore, I will judge you. Then, before he even finishes that verse, he said, repent and turn yourselves. He's telling us, my mercy is so near. My forgiveness is so near. And the blessing is so near. And even though you were marked for judgment, even though I was marked for judgment, even though the whole of the world were marked for judgment, before he finishes the verse, he tells us we can escape that judgment, but we'll escape. I said we'll escape, and then we'll get into the blessings of God. How will that happen? How will God do that?